Well, hello everybody, it's Richard here. Happy Tuesday. It's Tuesday the 20th of May 2020, and the temperature today has been, in the UK, has been really hot. It's 24 degrees now, and the time is 10 past 7. And this morning it was up to nearly 30 degrees in my garage workshop, which you will all know because you've seen my videos, and if you follow me regularly, you'll know that. If you're new to the channel, by the way, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell so you know when I'm next broadcasting. And I'm going to give you a bit of an update about what I've been doing today and what's going on in the press, and then I'm going to play the two records that I've got set aside for you and give you a bit of an update. And I've got some updates also about the little teaser I've been using for everybody, and I've got the replies. We've had four replies. Then I'm going to reveal who the winner is, and then tell you tell you the answer first, and then reveal what it is. But I've had some really, really good answers, and thank you for everybody for taking part, because I do like to interact with my audience quite well through the medium of YouTube, and that's what I'm doing now. So there we go. I went out for my run this morning, and it was really warm. I was in a very light T-shirt. And put plenty of sun cream on, factor 30 on this morning, because the sun was quite bright. So I was out before 8 o'clock, about 7:30 I left the house, and it was really nice. It was my second run, which is a Intermaidstone, then round the Millennium Park, and then back up into London Road, and back up to back down to the castle again. So yeah, and hardly any traffic. There was didn't see any people running the other way either, which is interesting. So, but yeah, otherwise I was then working, had some phone calls to make, catching up with people that I haven't spoken to for a while. It's been quite good. It's what's going on in the sector, the healthcare and health and social care sector that I work within. So that's been good. That leads nicely on to say that today, the government briefing we had this afternoon, there's been a total of 35,704 deaths, slightly down from yesterday. 363 people have died as from yesterday to today. And there are about 9,000 people in hospital, so that's slightly dead. I expect they will discharge them to care homes and probably end up with more deaths in care homes because of, though they should be testing them first, so I'm just being a bit silly, really. What else has happened today? Right, there we go. Let me just write this down here. Oh, yes. Right. Tom Moore. Captain Tom Moore. And I've got a really nice picture I'll post as I'm speaking. Captain Tom Moore, who was given an honorary colonel's position, I think he was. He raised £33 million for NHS charities. And he's been offered a knighthood, and Boris Johnson, our Prime Minister, put him forward. And because the knighthoods has been delayed in October this year, the ceremony, so I hope, though he's 100, I hope he manages to get his knighthood before he goes upstairs to heaven, because he is 100, although he looks very well, but you never know, do you, with a giant guy who's 100. But I'm really happy that he's been honoured in that way. I hope he's okay with having all these honours bestowed upon him for something that he started off walking up and down his driveway, though he calls it his garden, to raise £1,000, and we've raised £33 million. It's amazing, absolutely amazing. And he's a really lovely man. He was on breakfast television this morning. Thoroughly enjoyed watching that, and really happy for him. It really is a good news story, that one, apart from all the doom and gloom that I've been talking about over the last few weeks. Actually, I must count up how many days I've done now, because I'm losing count. It must be over 30, I think. But I thoroughly enjoy sitting here in the evening, chatting to you, and then getting on with the rest of my life. So there we go. Right, what else are we doing? Right, the paintwork for the garage door is now complete, and I'll put a picture of that as well. I've touched in the last bits, and looking absolutely very resplendent in its royal red, so I'm really pleased about that. So, and I was going to do a video of the day, but in fact, I can't think of one at the moment, so I think I'll come back tomorrow with that one. So the tune of the day today is going to be, we're going to have the last bit of side one for Bing Crosby here. And the last two tunes are, where are we? We had Stardust. The next one, Sweet and Lovely, which is an, funny enough, is an Al Boley number for me, because Al Boley sung that, and as a Hoggy Carmichael number. And Where the Blue of the Night, there we go. And then Paradise at the end, and then if the record finishes. So I think that's really sufficient to have of this side. I think you'd get bored if I played another side of that. But I know several of you have actually looked for this particular album set on eBay and been successful. The Brunswick one is the one that people like most. There is another one that came out on MCP, which is a later. This is the definitely the original, because the vinyl is quite thick on this. It's, though they say it's more like a very early vinyl. It's not very flexible. It's more like a plastic. And the label itself is very much in the old style, as you would see. It says Unbreakable Micro Groove Record. Well, I wouldn't like to test its unbreakability. I think I might leave that, actually. So, yeah, but great. And then the other one, of course, is Churchill Speeches, and I'm about halfway through record two. So I've done 4 minutes, and then I've cut it up to the point of where Japan was bombing Hiroshima, and also President Roosevelt Franklin is talking there. So I think that'd be quite good for today, and I'll do some more tomorrow. And tomorrow we'll play some more music as well. If you hear a fan in the background, it's because it's so warm in this office. It's so actually humid. It's 27 degrees and 24 outside. So I've got my favourite fan. I went up into the loft, which was quite warm, and dug it out this afternoon. It's sitting on the Vitrola VV50 there, like it did last year. The weather tomorrow is going to be a bit cooler, so I may not need it on, but it'll be there for the rest of the week. Next week's going to be warmer as well. So, which brings me nicely on to the X item. And thank you, everyone, for your nice views about my office space. If you want me to do a bit more, I'm quite happy to walk you round, because you know, it'd be interesting to see what people think. And people have been picking up clues as well as to what the thing for my next collection is. Right. So, let me just give you the ideas that people came up with. Andrew came up with a VW people carrier because he saw the one sits behind me. No, Andrew, that's not his, but good answer. I really like that one. A model car, which was Rob Parsons, who's a good friend of mine on Facebook. Rob, thank you so much for that offer, but it's near, but not the right answer. A baseball cap, Stuart Ellis said, or a teddy toy. So because I've got... Oh, I've got it outside, wearing it outside, actually. And because I've got a teddy... my little friend Peter Rabbit, who's here, he came with some Easter eggs, that's why I've got him here. And also a pet Neil thinks, because the rabbit needs carrots, which he reckons I could grow in the garden. Well, Neil, that's a fantastic answer, but it's not the right one. I did actually put something on here that would give you a hint, so I'm going to get the hint, but nobody picked up on it yesterday. It's probably because it was slightly out of shot, so excuse me a second. So I think Rob Parsons was the nearest, actually, nearest one, because in fact it's not a model car, it is actually a bath, and I've purchased a very nice, and I'll put a picture up on there, a Fiat Abarth 500 595, which is a really little pocket rocket, in a very resplendent grey colour. And I bought it on an auto trader from a lady who lives literally up the road. I could not believe my luck. So we met in Waitrose car park on several occasions, and then I've been across down to Maidstone to collect it today, and drove it home. And it's been sitting on the drive, looking at Passio, my Spider 124. I hope they get on well together, because they're both in the same stable in terms of the country. So yeah, so tomorrow I'm going to have a more in-depth look, and also be doing some COVID-19 cleaning. I have to say thank you to Sonia, who the lady owned it. She was the only owner. It's and it's only covered something like 27,000 miles, and it's been her daily drive, but she needs to have some money, so she's put it up for sale. and she's been really, really helpful. She had the car thoroughly validated before I received it, which I really was grateful. I wasn't expecting that at all. And also, she's given me all the provenance, so all the bills are there, and she's been very honest about what she's had done to it. And so I'm really happy about that. There is one or two things, there's a few dings on the alloy wheels, which I'll need to get sorted out. And I need to get a paint stick, there's a few chips on the front, which is normal, I suppose. But it sounds very nice when you start it up, and it's got a really nice exhaust. So I'm really looking forward to having some fun in that. And yeah, so Rob Parsons, you are the winner of the Richard McIntyre. Can you guess what's joining my collection? And I'll be posting some other bits about. It's the 595 Turismo, so I've called him Trizzy for short, Turisio. And it's got a very nice 1.4T turbo engine putting out, I think it's 163 brake horsepower, slightly less. Same engine as what the Spider's got in it, but the Spider puts out 171 bhp. So, but it is quick. I drove it up the road. It certainly moves pretty quick. It's a very lightweight car. But yeah, it's got beautiful leather seats and it's a C, so you get the nice sunroof, which goes back either fully or half. And yeah, good radio, so it sounds nice, good stereo. And but as I say, I haven't really had a chance to do much else to it. So you can always look it up. It's a 2016 model, so it's got the new rear lights. And yeah, I think it's really nice, actually. I think it's really lovely. I'm very happy with it. And so yeah, so here we are. And I bought myself a special fob for it today, or the other way, on eBay. So it's got the above, and so I should join. I'm already on the Facebook Abarth group, and I understand that there's a group in Maidstone who are hoping that I join them as well. So I'm looking forward to that. So there we are. That's all for this afternoon. I hope you're all keeping well. Let me know, and do keep in touch. And don't forget to subscribe if you're new. And I'll certainly post another video tomorrow, being a Thursday. I can't believe it's getting. I have actually got a conference call tomorrow, so I might do the video a little earlier, because that's an important meeting for me. But until then, stay safe, look after yourself, and bye for now.
I thought you would like me to tell you something about the voyage which I made across the ocean to meet our great friend, the President of the United States. Exactly where we met is a secret, but I don't think I shall be indiscreet if I go so far as to say that it was somewhere in the Atlantic. We had the idea when we met there, the President and I, that without attempting to draw final and formal peace aims or war aims, it was necessary to give all peoples, and especially the oppressed and conquered peoples, a simple, rough and ready wartime statement of the goal towards which the British Commonwealth and the United States mean to make their way. There are, however, two distinct and marked differences in this joint declaration from the attitude adopted by the Allies during the latter part of the last war, and no one should overlook them. The United States and Great Britain do not now assume that there will never be any more war again. On the contrary, we intend to take ample precautions to prevent its renewal in any period we can foresee by effectively disarming the guilty nations while remaining suitably protected ourselves. The second difference is this, that instead of trying to ruin German trade by all kinds of additional trade barriers and hindrances, as was the mood of 1917, we have definitely adopted the view that it is not in the interests of the world and of our two countries that any large nation should be unprosperous or shut out from the means of making a decent living for itself and its people by its industry and enterprise. These are far-reaching changes of principle upon which all countries should ponder. How near is the United States to war? There is certainly one man who knows the answer to that question. If Hitler has not yet declared war upon the United States, it is surely not out of his love for American institutions. It is certainly not because he could not find a pretext. He has murdered half a dozen countries for far less. Fear of immediately redoubling the tremendous energies now being employed against him is no doubt a restraining influence. But the real reason is, I am sure, to be found in the method to which he has so faithfully adhered and by which he has gained so much. It is a very simple method. One by one. That is his plan. That is his guiding rule. That is the trick by which he has enslaved so large a portion of the world. Never was the career of crime made more smooth. As soon as I heard last night that Japan had attacked the United States, I spoke to President Roosevelt on the Atlantic telephone with a view to arranging the timing of our respective declarations. The cabinet, therefore, which met at 12:30 today, authorized an immediate declaration of war upon Japan. Instructions to this effect were sent to our ambassador at Tokyo and the Japanese chargé d'affaires in London, and his staff have been given their passports. Look at the Londoners, the Cockneys. Look what they stood up to. Grim and gay with their cry, "We can take it," and their wartime mood. What's good enough for anybody is good enough for us. We have not asked that the rules of the game should be modified. If any, we shall never descend to the German and Japanese level. But if anybody likes to play rough, we can play rough too.
You know, anybody breaking into radio in 1931 had to have a theme song, sort of a musical identification. And Turk and Alert wrote me a good one, I thought. I've recorded it 5 or 6 different times with different groups and under different labels, but I imagine it's just got to be wedged in here someplace. When the blue of the night meets the goal of the day, someone waits for me, and the gold of her hair crowns the blue of her eyes like a halo. If only I could see her, oh, how happy I would be. When the blue of the night meets the goal of the day. Song, an old Calamity Jane putter, and three or four carefully nurtured strands atop my thinning noggin are about all I have left from 1931. But man, I treasure them all. Well, we got to get along here. Buddy, shall we then with Paradise? And then she holds my hand. And then I understand. Her eyes afire with one desire, then a heavenly kiss. Could I resist? And then she dims the light. And then she holds me tight. One kiss, one fond caress that leads the way to happiness. She takes me to paradise.